is going on, YouTubeverse? John Stanek from Johnny Radio here, bringing you another Top 5 on this glorious Top 5 Friday. And I couldn't be more excited than to be talking to you about one of my favorite artists of all time, from my favorite band of all time, the Beatles. We're talking John Lennon, and we're just going to focus on his solo material, because if I mix Beatles in there, I'd need to do a top 50. It would take hours. So let's get right to it, guys. At number 5...
Love is touch. Touch is love.
Love from Plastic Ono Band, his first solo record. Such a good album from start to finish. There, you know, he was going through primal scream therapy at the time, dealing with a lot of issues from his childhood and the breakup of the Beatles. So you had songs like Mother, Working Class Hero, God, and another one word, and the best of the bunch to me is Love, because all these songs are kind of raw and vulnerable, but this one is in such a beautiful way. And it's so simplistic, both musically and lyrically, when he's saying, love is real, real is love. If you were just reading it off of a paper, you'd be like, okay, yeah. But just his voice is so transparent and mixes beautifully with those chords, just the piano and acoustic guitar. It is gorgeous. So that's at my number 5. Now at number 4.
Nobody told me there'd be days like these. No one told me there'd be days like these. Nobody told me there'd be days.
Nobody told me, from Milk and Honey, which was released sadly after his tragic death. I believe the song was recorded the week that he was murdered, which is so sad to think about, especially just the fun, upbeat energy of this song. It is so rocking, and he's talking about kind of coming into the 80s saying, nobody told me there'd be days like these. Strange days indeed. It's just such a fun song, and you can tell that the other people playing on this track were just so into it as well. I really love the version. There was a box set of John Lennon of demos and outtakes in the early 2000s, and I love that version even more, because you just really feel the excitement in the studio when he counts it in, and it's just such a great song. So that is at my number 4. Now at number 3.
My love, for the first time in my life, my eyes are wide open.
Oh My Love from Imagine. Another just, I think, overlooked gem from this amazing album. And like Love before, this is also just a very beautiful ballad, obviously written to Yoko. And the music, again, is very sparse. It's just that piano and acoustic guitar. Add in some George Harrison electric guitar to take it over the top. But I just love the lyrics of this song, where he says, oh my love, for the first time in my life, my eyes are wide open. Just one of my favorite love ballads of all time. And just the way that the piano sounds, it almost sounds like a music box, like very classical, and just lovely. I think John really excelled at ballads, and I wish he was around to have given us more. But that is my number 3. Now we are at number 2.
This is calm, it's gonna get you. Gonna knock you right on the head.
Instant Karma from 1969. Yes, this was actually recorded pre-Beatles breakup or somewhere in between. I'm not exactly sure, but this is just one of those great songs that was written and recorded on the fly. I believe the day that he wrote the song, he's like, I gotta record this right now. He got Phil Spector and a bunch of musicians in a room, and they recorded it basically live with a bunch of reverb. And it's just such an awesome rocking song to this day. It just sounds timeless. It's got the classic raspy John Lennon, we all shine on. And it's so positive, while also on the verses kind of berating you, saying instant karma is gonna get you, better get your life together. I mean, It's got all the best things about Lennon, the biting sarcasm, the humor, the rock, everything. It's just so, so good. And that is at my number two. And now we are at number one. Of course, it had to be Imagine. You know, definitely by far, I think it's his best solo album. And I think not many people would argue that, you know, it's his best song. And one of the best songs ever written, period, by a human being. And, you know, like the ballads that I mentioned previously, Oh My Love and Love, he can take something so simple, just that simple piano riff, and add hardly anything. I think Ringo's barely touching the drums when they come in, light strings. It's just so tastefully produced, and the song is just lyrically as good as they come, you know, just saying essentially that we humans on the earth need to unite and be there for one another. And, you know, I just love that part in the song where he says, "You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one," you know. And, you know, it's really kind of like this utopian thought process to think that we could all love each other perfectly that way. But I think John really did get those moments of feeling, you know, who knows, maybe we could make a change in this world. And that's why he was one of the best artists of all time. And Imagine, absolutely one of the best songs of all time. It would probably be in my top five if I had to. Ooh, that's a good top five idea for the near future. But guys, thank you so much for watching. And let me know in the comments below, what is your top five? Even give me a top 10 if you're feeling so bold. And please continue to follow the channel. Top fives every Friday. We got album reviews. We got Heart of an Artist podcast. Much, much more to come. Thank you. And as always, Viva La Vinyl. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, all that jazz. Check out some of my other content that you can see on the screen now. Thank you again for supporting Johnny Radio. Take care, and I'll see you soon.